Pan and zoom is a great feature to make your images look more dynamic in the context of your video, or to enhance video footage. For example, you can start playing a video clip with the full frame in view, and gradually zoom in to show a specific subject in the video, then pan to show other subjects in the video. Conversely, you can start with a close-up of a subject in your video and gradually zoom out to show the full scene. You can also create a static zoom that does not change as the video plays. For example, a static zoom can be applied to a video captured with a tripod setup to capture a wide area. This is a great tool to use with 4K video because you can pan and zoom across your 4K video source and still get an HD result. It's easy to add a pan and zoom preset to your clip. Simply double-click the clip, select pan and zoom, and choose one of the presets. This is great if you just want a quick solution. If more control over the pan and zoom is needed, we can click the pan and zoom icon here, or click Customize Filter to edit the preset we just added. There are three editing modes for pan and zoom. Static is a constant zoom and area of focus. Animated lets us set keyframes to change the pan and zoom settings precisely. And On the Fly lets us set pan and zoom changes interactively in the preview pane while the video plays. Let's start with static mode. This is just for setting a zoom level and the position of the camera, which will then remain constant throughout the clip. We'll first set the level of zoom we want throughout the clip by dragging one of the corners on the box of the preview pane. And then we can reposition the box. Animated mode lets us add animation of the pan and zoom into the mix. This time, let's pan from the left edge at the start of the video. As we move the box via the red cross, we can see a white cross has been left behind. This represents the position of the box at the end of the pan and zoom. We can click this to jump straight to the end of the clip and position the box where we want, making it really quick to animate a custom pan and zoom. We can, of course, always add more keyframes between the start and end of the clip. Position the scrubber midway through the clip and press Add Keyframe. Then drag the box to where we want it to be midway through the clip. And let's also change the zoom level at this point by dragging one of the corners of the box. And we can see the result is a sweeping pan across the video clip with a zoom out at the middle of the shot. We can fine-tune the movement by dragging added keyframes. The third mode, On the Fly, has a few more options we can use with it. Firstly, we can set the preset size. This sets the zoom level to a standard size, so if we're using 4K footage, we can still render a video at HD quality without any distortion or pixelation from zooming in too close onto the video, as long as we don't make the zoom smaller than the preset we chose. The great thing about On the Fly mode is you can intuitively adjust the pan and zoom animation as the video plays. Play the clip and then drag the box where you want it to appear at that point. And keyframes are added automatically to reflect the movement. And you can change the zoom level as well whilst the clip plays. It will pause for you whilst you're setting your zoom. As you can see, keyframes are generated each time you set a new location or zoom level, one at the point you made the edit, and another just before, so the pan or zoom is quick and snappy. If you want to change this default behavior, just click Ease In. Ease In is a setting that affects how quickly the pan and zoom moves towards its location. With this checked, the extra keyframe before your edit is not added, so the pan or zoom starts from the previous keyframe in your clip. This makes the results more fluid and organic than a quick pan or zoom. We can then go in and edit the keyframes if necessary, but hopefully now you've got some great ideas on how to create your own stunning pan and zooms. Just click OK to add the finished pan and zoom to your project. And you can always go back and edit by going to Customize Filter once more. All your keyframes are retained in case you want to make a change.